Good morning and welcome. At this time, I ask that you please silence your cell phones and electronic devices. Please stand for the processional and remain standing for the presentation of colors, followed by the national anthem performed by KHS Band and Choir. And please welcome our seniors, Ashley Castellanos and Maggie Wallace, for that singing. Thank you. You may be seated. Good morning. I'd like to now introduce our senior class president, Kelsey Cotton, for this morning's welcome. Please welcome her to the stage.
Hi. Wow. I'm happy to welcome family, friends, teachers, and most importantly, graduates here today to our 2013 senior graduation ceremony. If you'd have asked me 4 years ago if I thought I'd be standing here today, I would have thought you were crazy. But I'm happy and proud to have been given the opportunity to represent our class. So thank you, families and teachers, for giving us the opportunities that we needed in order to be able to be here today, and for believing in us even when we lost all hope in ourselves. We will be forever grateful to you all. However, this one is for the graduates. To all the weirdos, and this I can say, because standing here before you today is a weirdo herself. But no, this is true. There is no one I'd rather be a weirdo with than you. We all have a place in this world in our home, and the beauty is not having to find it alone. Though our talents and wishes may drive us apart, we can walk away today knowing in our hearts that we walk away together to start something new that will take us away, make us strong, and let us do what we never thought we could. So today is the day we give up our childhood dreams and take in the world, our world, not for how it seems, but rather for what it can be. So we choose how to give back in the ways that demonstrate why we love to live and what we love to live for. But what isn't true is that you have to live and choose based on someone else's view of what is great or worthy. Do not let others define the dreams that you have or the means that you find of achieving them, because in the end, it isn't the wrongs that we've written or the shames we have to mend, but rather the hope that we carry that makes us grow into the kind of people that everyone wants to know and aspire to be. When we started our journey, we were who everyone thought, the ones thought about often, and the ones really not thought about at all. We were all insecure and didn't think we'd find anyone as lost, scared, and kind as ourselves. And then one day we realized what it meant to share that loneliness, nervousness, and kindness until someone out there would accept and return it. And thus friendships were made, our loneliness gone, and our sanity saved by the ones that were once so different from us. Yet it gave us hope, made us tough, and taught us to trust ourselves while accepting one another. And now we are equals, no one above the other. So now it is our job to take what we know, what we've learned from each other that made us grow into who we are today, to the world outside, so that we can teach others to love themselves and take pride in all the things they do well. We must face our fears and trust that we can do whatever we want and be whoever we want to be as we find our new place in the world. Except now, we aren't those lost children, insecure and wondering how to be okay. No. Now we are people not afraid to try to accept our faults, hold out our hands, and open our eyes to the possibilities. So for all you once were weirdos standing with me today, it is my honor and privilege to finally say, we made it. We did it. And from now on, we'll be seen as a group I'm proud to belong to, the class of 2013. Thank you. Mr. Hickman.
I'm pleased to recognize the students that have earned the Knights of Distinction honor. Please stand if you're one of those students. These students had to maintain a 3.0 GPA, earn 4 credits in music, art, world language, or CTE coursework, and earn a C or better in at least 2 honors courses. They also met or exceeded the state standards for the PSAE or Prairie State Achievement Exam in all areas. Please give them a round of applause. You may be seated. I'd like to now welcome to the podium the class of 2013 salutatorian Nathaniel Snyder. Nathaniel will be studying business at Ole Miss on an academic scholarship.
First and foremost, I'd like to dedicate this speech to Sam Reimars and Matt Rodway. Good morning, fellow graduates, school board members, staff, family, and friends. First, I'd like to thank everyone in attendance today. All of you, family, friends, and teachers have had profound impact on the development of students who are graduating. I know I wouldn't be up here today if I didn't have my parents' guidance. I would also like to give a special thank you to a few outstanding teachers. Most of my teachers at Kaneland were great, yet the most recent ones who stand out are Mr. Larson, Mr. Dentino, Mr. Carter, and Ms. Beck. Thank you for your dedication to challenge and inspire me. When I first sat down to write this speech, I had no idea where to begin. I didn't know if I was going to stand up in front of 1,500 people and reminisce on good memories, or just pass out. I actually contemplated reading lyrics from my favorite artist, 2 Chainz, just to save myself some time. Then I remembered that diplomas are handed out after the ceremony, so I decided against it. In true senioritis fashion, I sat down the day it was due and got to work. Looking at you, class of 2013, I'm realizing today is the last day we will all be together in one place. The future is a mystery for all of us, yet it is important to continuously pursue whatever makes you happy. I have no doubt that many of you will become extremely successful in your careers, but it is important to remember how to measure success. Steve Jobs said it best, if today were the last day of my life, what I want to do, what I'm about to do today, and whenever the answer has been no for too many days in a row, I know I need to change something. We have our whole lives ahead of us. I wish you all nothing but success. Just remember that success isn't measured by the degrees you attain, the jobs you land, the money you earn, the power you possess. Rather, you can measure your success by something you'll never witness, the length of your visitation line at your own funeral. I'll summarize with a quote from Ellen DeGeneres. Follow your passion. Stay true to yourself. Never follow someone else's path unless you're in the woods and you're lost and you see a path. By all means, you should follow that. Thank you.
Please welcome to the podium class of 2013 valedictorian, Ms. Kate Dre. Kate will be studying biomedical engineering and mathematics at Kentucky University on an academic scholarship.
I'd like to start off by thanking the group of people without whom I would not be standing here today, my friends, my family, and the MIT crew. These people have given me countless memories, have forced me out of my comfort zone, and I honestly could not imagine my life without them. I'd also like to acknowledge the adults in my life who inspired me, matured me, and taught me more about life than I could ever imagine. To my mom and dad, thank you for supporting me without fail for the past 18 years. Mr. Dentino, your constant excitement for and knowledge of the world of mathematics is astounding. Mr. C, I am in awe of how you dealt with our French class for 4 entire years without going insane. And Giovanni Islas, my incredible manager at McDonald's, you have given me so many examples of how to deal with whatever life throws at you, whether it's 10 number 10s or something more serious. With that said, I'd like to congratulate the class of 2013 for finally making it through these past 13 years. It's only just beginning to hit me that it's over. High school is over, and ahead of us lie the rest of our lives, the good, the bad, and the ugly. So this summer, surround yourself with the people that make you happy. Stay up all night when you have to work in the morning. Do things that make you feel alive. Take the advice of Hemingway and live the full life of the mind, exhilarated by new ideas and intoxicated by the romance of the unusual. Don't let your preparations for the future inhibit your present. Spend time with the people that actually matter, the unexpected people, the people that challenge your perceptions, and the people that make you appreciate parts of your life that you've never considered before. Inhale the present and forget about everything else because this summer is it. From then on, we're adults. We're responsible for our own triumphs and for our own failures in it by ourselves and for ourselves. If we're being honest, I think we can all admit that our lives so far are unimportant in the grand scheme of things. Our memories of the dull dramas, the futile fights, and the burning betrayals will fade, as will the reminiscences of our first loves and our epic escapades. For better or for worse, we are done. If high school ends up being the best part of our lives, we did something wrong, and if it ends up being the best, if it ends up being the worst, we are lucky. We have our whole lives ahead of us. Go live them. Congratulations, class of 2013. We made it.
Please welcome to the stage today's keynote speaker, Mr. Jim McKnight. Jim has been teaching at Kaneland High School for 26 years, both as a math and science teacher. This senior class has been so incredible, I thought they had earned the right to choose their keynote speaker, and they have chosen Mr. McKnight. Thank you for doing so.
Thank you. Welcome, everyone. Thank you all for being here. It's a great honor and privilege for me to stand in front of you today. And this is probably the greatest honor I've ever had. I'd really like to talk for about 45 minutes, but this isn't the Senior Athletic Awards ceremony. Sorry, I just had to have a little fun with that. As many of you know, it was just about a year ago that I almost died. And I wanted to talk a little bit about that because I think there are some lessons there for all of us. For one thing, I'm comfortable with the fact that what happened to me was an accident, that my poor little pet, Spunky, never meant to harm me. She was very sick and near death and was experiencing a seizure. She only bit me because my hand was in the way of her when she was going through a seizure, and I did not want her to fall off the bed. And she bit me only because that was an instinctive thing to do. And I'm comfortable with that. I've never held any grudges. I've never been angry. I'm just thankful that I'm still here. In fact, Spunky and Teeny, her twin sister, and I, every morning we would have breakfast together, usually out of the same cereal bowl. Every evening we would have playtime, and then a bedtime snack, and then it was time for me to go to bed and for the girls to play in their cage all night. Or maybe it was the other way around, I don't know. But I think the lesson there is that we don't want to go through life angry, bitter, resentful. We need to experience closure and put those bad things behind us as quickly as possible. Because, you know, if you hold grudges against someone or something, then that person or thing continues to defeat you over and over and over again. How true. Now, I also wanted to mention a lesson that I learned about family and friends and relatives, because you know we take these things for granted, these people for granted, and I think we need to use these people to our advantage, but we need to repay kindness with kindness. Treat them as though we want to give to them as we would like to receive. And we don't ever want to let petty things ruin relationships, because I found that life really is too short for that. I'd like to mention how family and friends and relatives can be helpful, because in my case, you know, I knew that I should probably seek medical help, and yet a full week went by before I was finally, literally, dragged to the hospital and was literally within minutes of dying. But thankfully, my older daughter, Elisa, and my wife were able to convince me and to get me into the car and take me. And actually, the last thing I remember was falling out of the car at the emergency room of Kishwaukee Hospital. And I banged up my knees really bad, and I still have scars, but I didn't feel any pain. And I just lay there on the pavement. It was so hot, but it felt so good, because I found out my body temperature was only 95 degrees. They couldn't get a blood pressure reading. My organs were all shutting down. I was losing consciousness, and I was so near death that it was a true miracle that I survived. And my younger daughter, Kelly, and her husband, Russ, dropped everything and came as soon as they could. It was a 300-mile drive for them, but they came. and my sister Jane and family from Detroit. There again, she gave up everything, got on the plane, and was there within hours. And she stayed, and she didn't want to go home, and she was there day and night. And my brother Jeff, who was able to bring my mom and dad, who were in their mid-80s, and he kept coming back after work each day, 200 miles every day. But he did that for me. And my poor dad and mom, who you can imagine must have been going through an amazing time, thinking that their grown son was probably not going to make it. And how do you react to that? What do you say? Especially when I was in a coma and I had no idea what was going on. And they stayed 6.5 weeks. They were there. And that's partially in thanks to my wonderful sister-in-law, Carol, who gave her the key to her home and insisted that they stay. And so they did. And every morning they were at the hospital before 7 a.m. and they'd stay till late at night. And the next day they would be right back there again to do it all over, just to be there for me. And these things, along with you people, because so many of you came to see me and you followed my story on Facebook and Twitter and all those other electronic things I don't understand. And yet, you were there with me, and I appreciate that. And teachers and administrators and former teachers and friends and family, all the emails and the messages and the cards and the thoughts and the prayers and the gifts, and it was just overwhelming. And that continues, thankfully. And I guess it's always going to be there for me. And, you know, another lesson is that you need to hang in there, no matter how bad things are. You hang in there. And, you know, I still have some problems. I'm not the same person I was, and sometimes I find it difficult to say the words I want to say. And yet, I think I'm probably in better health now than a lot of people twice my age. So that's kind of cool if you think about it. I don't think there is anybody twice my age. Do you think that life is really fair? Because I think sometimes maybe it's not. And yet, maybe I can give you an example. I was thinking when I was doing grades the other day, okay, I have 127 students. What if I do a perfect job with 126 and I mess up on one? You know what? That one really matters. And that's what's going to get noticed. The other 126, it's not going to get noticed. The one bad thing is going to get noticed. And so it is with life and the way we live, too. Let's look at it a different way. Let's say you wrote an essay and you turn that in and your teacher says, you know, there's only one little corner of this essay where I can smell cat spray, and so you deserve an A. That'd be kind of cool, wouldn't it? And maybe your mom says, you know, you have almost no holes in your clothes today. I think you're good to go. And what about your last trip to the dentist? What sounds do you remember? What smells do you remember? Is it the really good stuff, or is it the bad stuff? See what gets noticed sometimes? And how about the places you visited? Do you remember the everyday things? Maybe not. But the really good and the really bad? Sure. We remember those things. And what about your high school class? What are you going to remember about each other, about your teachers, about your experiences? I wish I had just one day I could go back to high school and live that over again, no matter how mundane it might have been. But what are we going to remember? We're going to remember those really good things, aren't we? We're going to remember some of those really bad and embarrassing, evil things, too. That's the way we are. So what's the lesson? Maybe we should live our lives remembering that people are going to remember the really good things that we do, the really good person that we are. And we don't want it to be the other way around. Before I'm done, I wanted to talk about your lucky number 13, because I'm not so sure that's an unlucky number. I wanted to point out a few examples why it's so lucky for me. When I played sports, all through grade school and high school, somehow I always got the number 13. And I became so comfortable with that, I thought, this is my number now. So eventually, I actually tried to get number 13. That seemed to be good luck for me. And when I was growing up, one of my favorite TV shows was called The Munsters. And can you guess where the Munsters lived? 1313 Mockingbird Lane. How can you forget that? And the last time I spoke in front of a graduating class was my own high school graduation, when I gave the valedictory address. And for the benefit of you math teachers and those of you who are not math challenged, you know how long ago that was? It was greater than or equal to 13 years ago. Okay, actually it was about 13 plus 13 plus 13 plus 1. But who would know? And you know what? My first child, Elisa, was born on the 13th of September. And my younger daughter, Kelly, recently presented me with my first grandchild. And her first child, my parents' first great-grandchild, guess when she was born? 1-3-1-3. Isn't that something? And 13 weeks after I entered the hospital, I was finally given permission to return to Kaneland part-time. And that document was signed on October 13th. So I don't think 13 is such a bad number. And I think you as a class are incredibly special. I do have a couple of challenges for you, however. I would like to challenge you to always do what's best and appropriate. Because in college, sometimes you might even get to choose what your grade is going to be, especially in grad school. And the teacher will say, all right, you choose A, B, or C. What's the difference? How much work you do. That's all that matters. So I remember one course here at NIU, and I chose the A option, naturally. And I probably would have gotten an A, but my professor called me into his office one day and asked me to read a book and to give a report to the rest of the class. He didn't say there would be any extra credit. He didn't say there would be a guaranteed A. He didn't say there would be any reward whatsoever. He just asked me to do it. And I didn't question it. I didn't ask, what's in it for me? You know? I just did it. And I was working part-time 25 hours a week, and I was taking 17 graduate hours. And I knew it was going to be a challenge, but I did it. And I did get an A in that class, but I don't know whether that assignment had anything to do with it or not. And I guess it really doesn't matter, but I did what I was asked to do. And that reminds me, just a few years ago, my family was vacationing up in Minocqua, Wisconsin, and driving rain, about 8 feet per hour. And my dad and I were comfortably in the cab of the truck. My brother was in the boat, and he was tending to some things back there, and he was just absolutely soaked. And we stopped, and my dad looked at me, and he said, "Jim, go help your brother." And I didn't question it. I didn't say, "But Dad, it's raining," or "I'm tired," or "I shouldn't have to do that," or "What's in it for me?" No, you see, my dad thought that the yellow, light, cotton, thin shirt that I was wearing was my raincoat. He didn't know that it wasn't. But I didn't question it. That was my dad who told me to go out and help my brother. And in less than 2 seconds, I was out the door and I was helping my brother. And we can joke about that now because it's hilarious. But it goes to show, sometimes we need to just do what we're asked to do what we're told to do, without regard to what is in it for me. And I would like to perhaps challenge you to do that. Now, I have a secret challenge also. I would like to challenge all of you to spend the next 13 weeks without Facebook or cell phones or computers, just so you can experience what life was like for your poor parents and grandparents. Okay, maybe that won't work too well. But I do have a legitimate challenge for you. And that is, and please don't ever forget these words, because as you go through life, try to go beyond what's average. Do everything better than just good enough to get by. Take pride in yourself and in what you do. Do things because you have to and because you want to. I wish all of you the very best in everything. I salute you. RTM forever. Thank you.
Thank you, Jim. Nice job. Please welcome back to the podium, Ms. Kelsey Cotton.
On behalf of the Senior Student Council and the senior class, we would like to put the money towards our class gift towards purchasing an electronic marquee for the front of the high school building, just like the classes have done before us and will hopefully continue to do in the future. And now, graduates, if you will please join me in what will begin the graduation ceremony. As we move our tassels from our right to our left side, take a moment and feel that gratitude and pride in yourselves and all of us that we're here today and this is it. And we did everything we could, and I'm proud of who we are. I'm proud of our class. I think that we show an immense amount of strength and courage, and I'm really proud of who we are today, guys. So this is it. Congratulations.
At this time, we will begin presenting the diplomas to our graduates.
Mrs. Welker and the graduating class in the first row, if you could please stand and begin joining us on stage. Family, friends, students, and staff, We'd ask that you please hold your applause and acknowledgments until all names have been shared. Thank you. Carlos D. Aguilar, Jr. Gabriella E. Aguirre. Stephanie E. Arndt. Clayton J. Akey. Nicholas C. Albano. Brittany E. Allen. Caitlin G. Anderson. Kyle R. Anderson. Alyssa D. Andre. Tanner L. Andrews. Julia N. Angelotti. Eduardo R. Redondo. Ruby A. Astorga. Bridget K. Osberry. Marissa S. Avery. Olabukola F. A. Abusi. Daniel J. Baldinari, Jr. Lauren N. Banbury. David C. Barnhart. Joanna Berrigan. Caitlin N. Barsick. Cammy M. Bauer. Alex M. Baumgartner. Jeffrey D. Bergstrom. Spencer M. Bergstrom. Elizabeth N. Berland. Jennifer A. Bikos. Jason L. Biddle. Clark N. Bittner, Jr. Frank P. Blanche. Ellen E. Bowen. Colin W. Bourne. Haley E. Boyd. Blake H. Bradford. Emma R. Bradford. Joseph B. Brassfield. Erica M. Bretman. Sarah R. Briggs. Margaret M. Brundage. Bailey C. Burns. Kendall R. Callahan. Justin R. Campbell. Natasha N. Capes. Angelia P. Carbonara. Cameron J. Carlson. Samantha T. Carney. Romina Carnano. Marisol Carrera. Alexis Carrillo. Ashley M. Castellanos. Angela C. Charhut. Miles H. D. Chick. Jacob A. Childress. Cameron M. Ciccone. Brianne C. Claypool. Rachel L. Clinton. Donato V. Colonese. Joshua A. Kors. Madeline G. Cole. Bridget Contreras. Vanessa R. Cook. Brandon T. Cartier. Kelsey E. Cotton. Kyle R. Crawford. Nicholas M. Crawford. Anna E. Croft. Selena Cuiar-Reyes. Dana L. Davies. Alexis A. Davis. Austin C. Davis. Lane A. Davis. Robert T. DeBolt. Lakin T. Delahante. Cynthia N. DeLeo. Noel R. Delegado. Claiborne M. Denlinger. Joseph S. Devershowski. Hannah N. Dewar. Rafael Diaz. Natalie S. Dietrich. Eric M. Dillon. Abigail M. Dodis. Alonzo Dominguez. Miracle Dominguez. Katrina E. Donnelly. Austin L. Doyle. Caitlin E. Dre. Brendan P. Dumphy. Elizabeth R. Eckert. Zachary T. Eckhart. Carolyn E. Eichelberger. Nicole C. Elliott. Hunter A. Amy. Caesar Estrada II. Ryan R. Uting. Brianna N. Evola. Brett W. Evola. Christopher T. Farrell. Lucas Jeff Ferris. Marshall L. Farthing. Emily K. Farrell. Sean P. Flamand. Terrence P. Foley. Ryan C. Ford. Kristen M. Gabrielson. Dominique R. Galloway. Samantha M. Garcia. Cynthia Gayton. Austin J. Gibson. Anna Marie N. Geese. Alexander J. Gill. Jordan T. Gunther. Sean T. Glennon. Gwendolyn S. Goldthwaite. Zachary J. Gomez. Daniel A. Gores. Sarah T. Grams. Jack M. Grimes. K. Carrie-Anne E. Green. Nicole M. Grossman. Emily N. Galansic. Stephen C. Gust. Christian D. Guzman. Nicholas J. Hale. Destiny R. Haller. Nicole M. Hanlon. Allison J. Harner. Brooke K. Harner. Corey J. Harner. Andrew J. Harper. William F. Hart III. Tyler J. Haubecker. Reagan G. Healy. Alexander J. Held. David J. Hernandez. Janice M. Hyab. Kirsten N. Hines. Megan A. Holloman. Keel R. Homa. John D. Hopkins. Jameson R. Horn. Brandon M. Huber. Austin A. Huckle. Kushtreem Ishmali. Cheyenne C. Jansen. Graham J. Jefferson. Garrett L. Jennings. Lisa M. Jennings. Bradley R. Johnson. Brandon J. A. Johnson. Connor D. Johnson. Michael T. Kirikortis. Nicholas M. Katsiganis. Tyler J. Keenum. Catherine G. Kinkel. Aaron M. Kettlecamp. Brad M. Kigis. Samuel J. Kilgore. Michael C. Kinder. Alexa C. King. Anna P. King. Sage P. Kinney. Alec R. Koska. Jessica A. Colzo. Esther S. Kong. Jennifer D. Kopis. Alexander J. Kovach. Taylor T. Krawcheck. Luke N. Kreider. Rebecca A. Kratz. Matthew G. Kucera. Jamie K. Kufer. Joseph W. Kuipers. Alexis C. Gara. Nicholas J. Lakey. Bailey M. Lancaster. Brittany R. Larson. Ryan W. Lawrence. Reginald D. Lee, Jr. Tanisha H. Lee. Kara M. Linhart. Amanda M. Lisak. Kara J. Layden. Matthew J. Limbrunner. Allison S. Liss. Chad A. Logan, Jr. Cody C. Long. Benjamin T. Longson. Catherine M. Lucarelli. Sydney C. Luce. Alexandra E. Lyons.
And the second part of our alphabet. As we switch sides here, can you prepare to come up and receive your diplomas? Brian C. McTrinder. Thomas Madriz. Emily R. Mackey. Dakota D. Manella. Stephanie J. Maris. Samantha M. Markels. Kelsey I. Marco. J. A. Markison. Zachary R. Martinelli. Tive A. Mattis. Kelly A. McCarthy. Jacqueline N. McClellan. Danielle N. McCormick. Stephen M. McCracken. Raven K. McFarland. Russell E. McGill, Jr. Joshua D. McHenry. Madeline S. McMullen. John Meisinger. James V. Merletti. Nicholas J. Messina. Eric A. Muir. Savannah H. Miles. Braden K. Miller. Daniel M. Miller. Emma M. Moon. Mary Pat Mowell. Liam M. Malloy. Paige M. Knockreiner. Brianna N. Naden. Alyssa R. Naley. Marinelli Navarro. Benjamin E. Nelson. J. D. Nelson. Michaela R. Ness. Michael D. Navarez. Morgan T. Newhouse. Tyler J. Nix. Alyssa M. Nolte. Corey J. Nordine. Sarah J. Norman. Brandy N. Norton. Allison K. O'Haron. Jessica H. Obremski. Kyle A. Ocasio. Diego Ochoa. Bo C. Ott. Courtney D. Perotto. Jacob M. Perry. Ryan C. Paulson. Evelyn M. Pekas. Kayla M. Pence. Dylan J. Pennington. Andrea V. Peterson. Nicholas A. Phillips. Riley N. Phillips. Kaylee M. Pinkston. Tyler M. Plant Bellock. Adam J. Pachekai. Joseph A. Palestrini. Kyle V. Palestrini. Asai G. Ponce. Mackenzie R. Powell. Ashley R. Prost. Dylan T. Radke. Elijah A. Ramos Orbi. Maxim D. Rieger. Natasha L. Ring. Edwin R. Rodriguez. Matthew T. Rodway. Jessica N. Ruckte. Lauren A. Rusnak. Samuel S. Reimars. Ruben Salazar. Anne M. Salerno. Vincent M. Sanchez. Michael X. Saucedo. Lindy M. Scholl. Christina M. Schrems. Colin B. Seidelman. Megan L. Salenis. Trisha E. Selmer. Zachary M. Selmer. Nicholas D. Sharp. Heather A. Shelton. Stephen M. Simmons. Joshua C. Sitterly. Jessica A. Smith. Megan K. Smith. Nathaniel R. Snyder. Benjamin L. Summers. Rachel E. Sorensen. Carissa E. Sotelo. Morgan A. Southern. Blake J. Sowell. Samantha J. Sparks. Kayla L. Stasel. Savannah M. Stasek. Morgan T. Stewart. Marcus V. Stott. Brian E. Stover. Ryan J. Strawn. Amanda L. Stravey. Elizabeth M. Such. Chad M. Suica. Fran Sikowski. Zachary R. Tice. Jacob R. Filk. Andrew D. Tobin. Eduardo J. Torres. Tanya A. Toscano. Kalani N. Tovar. Shayna M. Tusek. Jack J. Van Gemert. Taylor M. Velasquez. Alexandra S. Vickery. Matthew W. Walgren. Kaylee A. Wald. Gemma T. Waldrop. Caitlin M. Wallace. Seth B. Weiss. Caitlin N. Wendling. Abby R. West. Christopher Wido. Abby R. Wilhelm. Mark D. Willie. Alicia L. Williams. Connor J. Williams. Alexander J. Willis. George M. Wilson. Danielle O. Witz. Morgan A. Wojciechowski. Jordan J. Wolf. Jessica L. Woodward. Joshua Worley. Danielle L. Wiley. And Nicholas W. Yankula. At this time, we would like to introduce the Kaneland High School Madrigals and the senior choral members of our choir, directed by Mr. Brian Kuntzman.
Thank you to our senior madrigals. As always, you're excellent. Also want to take a moment and thank our senior choir director, Mr. Brian Kuntzman, and our band director, Mr. Aaron Puckett. Thank you for your leadership and for your development of young people. For our closing, I'd like to welcome to the podium Mr. Sean Flamand.
Well, if I pass out, I want to let you guys know it's not from nerves. I got a solid 3 hours of sleep last night, so. All right. Well, here I am. I'm the last speech you guys have to agonize through before we all walk off to college, and then it's on to the real world. I promise you, though, it's short, and I really hope I don't drop the pie on this. For everyone, high school is a new experience. For me, it was a terrifyingly alien scenario unlike anything else I'd ever had to do. I had been homeschooled all the way up until my freshman year. Going to public school for the first time was probably the most nerve-wracking thing I had ever done or will ever do. I was nerdy, I was weird, well, nerdier, weirder, but somehow that still didn't matter. And it was the students of our class of 2013 who made it okay. And I can't mention everyone, but I have to thank a few people. Eddie, you took me under your wing. You let me hang out with you and your group of friends, and we grew apart eventually. We rarely see each other, but that just happens. You may not remember what you did for me, but I do, and I thank you. Ryan, you're probably the weirdest person I have ever encountered in my entire life. And I don't really know how to feel about that, but you're a great friend. And you, along with Kate, Kyle, Noel, Juan, Gio, everybody else from the McCrew, you guys make me love coming to work every day. To my whole family, ever expanding as it is, thank you guys for putting up with me, whether it's money, motivation, or just dealing with all of my really bad moods. Nick, you're a ginger, and you dropped the pie. And I really, really hope that you know that no one will ever let you forget that. You've always been there for me, and no matter how much we get on each other's nerves sometimes, you are one of my greatest friends. And Dominique, you are my best friend, and always will be, even if you can't count to three. You and Nick show me what a turtle I am and how to crawl out of my shell every once in a while. And I know you guys will always argue over who called me turtle in the first place, but seriously, we all know it was you. I couldn't possibly talk about everyone, so I won't. Just know that there is no other class I'd rather be a part of. This class made me who I am today. You took me in, You gave me a new name, and you changed me for the better. You showed me how to socialize, how to treat people the right way, and accept them. You showed me firsthand how important it is to expand your horizons and break down your barriers to talk to new people. College will be just as new for us, but I'm going to remember all the lessons that this school taught me. Kaneland taught me to come out of my shell and be myself, and that's something we can all identify with, amphibious or not. And whenever you're about to overthink something, like I always do, recuerden la tortuga, remember the turtle. He only makes progress when he sticks his neck out. Class of 2013, I thank you all. Enjoy the rest of your lives.
The Board of Education, administration, all of our instructional and support staff across the district want to thank the community, friends, and family that joined us for this celebration. We want to congratulate our graduates on this achievement. We wish you the best in your next journey. Please stand as I present to you the class of 2013. Remain standing through the processional.